What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Sunday late morning, 11:25 here in the morning in the great state of New York on Sunday, December 28th, 2025. I'm heading back to that service call, that Trane XE80 that I went to on Friday, the day after Christmas, when the shop was closed, emergency service call, no heat. And we had that high limit plenum sensor failure where it was blowing fuses once everything heated up, no bueno. Anyway, supplyhouse.com came through. I ordered it on Friday, late morning, early afternoon. I had it shipped to my house because it's a residential address, and UPS delivered it yesterday, which was Saturday. What is this guy doing? Look at this. Don't you know how to signal? What a moron. You see this? Sorry, guys. Trying to keep it family friendly here, but any case, smash that thumbs up button, hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and hit that alarm bell to get post notifications when I drop a video. We're right down the block from the customer's location. I'm gonna try to sign them up for a maintenance plan. That way we can come there twice a year, once for the air conditioning, once for the heating, and take care of them. So, and hopefully use my Meta glasses and record content of the repair, including I'm going to diagnose again and show you how this high limit sensor was grounding out, step by step, how I get that done. Let's go. All right, here is that Trane XE80, 140,000 BTUs. Yeah, 140,000 BTUs, but that right there is our problem. And I'm going to show you how we tested that to show the shorts to ground. We got the power off. We're going to get our voltmeter. We're going to take out that 12-pin harness Smolex connector right here. Okay. And I'm going to show you how we did that. All right, I got my multimeter set to read continuity. I have one of my leads with the alligator clip on the chassis. Now it's not a good solid connection. There you go. So now, take a look at this. Continuity. See? Pushing on that high limit sensor causes it to ground out on one side. Blows the fuse. Crazy. Looks normal. Good. See? Now we good. Crazy. I don't know how that was, but when this was secured down, oh, maybe there somewhere. Yeah. Crazy though. All right. Harness, and let's actually reconnect the AC. I left it disconnected. Let's plug that back in. All right, common and yellow. All right, there's our inducer getting that call for heat. Once the pressure switch senses that pressure, the inducer motor creates, pressure switch closes. As long as our rollouts are good and our high limit is under temp, we'll have a power going to our hot service igniter, which will then start to glow in that right hand corner. It's back there. See it? Wait for it.
if you're not calling Mikey Pipes, you're getting screwed.
There you go. That's right.